Welcome back to Winning Law. I'm attorney David Wayne with offices in Houston, Texas. And today we're going to discuss three more tips and tricks that USCIS officers have when determining whether or not a marriage is entered into in good faith. Tip number seven, immigration has access to your DMV records. So if you apply for a driver's license or state ID with your Department of Motor Vehicles, immigration has access to when and if you filed your address change. So if you have a pending case with immigration, you should know that even though you are required by law to file the form AR-11, which is a change of address form, you still have the obligation of ensuring that you are adhering to state laws. Many states, and I'm assuming most states, require that you change your address on your driver's license within a couple of days after you move. And couples are notorious for forgetting to do this. So if you move while your application is pending, make sure that you go out to the DMV and you get your address changed on your driver's licenses or state IDs right away. Do not wait until the day before the interview or a week before, because the government is going to know this. They're going to question you, why did you wait so long to change your address on your driver's licenses or state IDs? And no matter what excuse you give, no matter if you say that you're too busy working, you have too many kids to take care of, they're not going to care, and they're going to use this against you when making a determination on whether or not you and your spouse live together. So again, if you move, no matter how many times you move, you need to go, and I know it's a hassle, but you have to go and get your driver's license or state ID changed. The eighth trick or tool that USCIS immigration officers have is that they have access to the Department of State's visa application. So when foreign nationals come to the US, you have to apply for a visa to enter the US. Either you fill out a form DS-160 for a non-immigrant visa or DS-260 for an immigrant visa. Well, most of the time, foreign nationals do not keep these records, and when they hire an immigration attorney to file their green card application, those records are not available, and the attorney can only work with the information that the foreign national remembers or has in their possession. And this is a big issue, because if a foreign national lied on their DS-160 or 260 application before they came to the U.S., the immigration attorney first doesn't know this. And also, immigration officers are trained to review the application to ensure that the foreign national did not make any misrepresentations. Now, let me give you a couple of examples. If a foreign national fills out the DS-160 or 260, and they put down that they had two children, but after when they apply for the green card application, they indicate they have three children, there's an inconsistency there, and immigration will pick this up. Also, if a foreign national indicated that they were working at a certain place, immigration may want to see an employment verification letter just to ensure that that person didn't make up that job. And if the person said they were married and they really weren't, this also causes a big issue. So when you're filing your visa application to obtain a visa, never, never, never lie to the visa officer, because it's going to cause you a lot of heartache and a lot of problems when you apply for a green card inside the United States. The final tool or trick that immigration officers have when making a determination on whether a marriage is entered in good faith involves just the inexperience of the person filling out the forms. So if you're at home and you're thinking that immigration, these forms don't look that bad, I can fill it out myself and submit it, let me explain why you should always use an attorney. And it's because immigration, they actually have a law that states that even innocent mistakes can be considered material misrepresentations that can cause a person to be denied their green card. So let's say, for example, you fill out the forms and you fill out something wrong and it was just an accident, or you believe that, hey, I'll explain this during the interview. This could be used to your detriment. Let me give you a very, very good example. I had a couple that came to me. The foreign national, she had a prior spouse, She applied for her visa and it was denied. And years later, she met someone new and she married that person. And then she came to the US, obtained a fiance visa, came to the US, and then filed her green card application. Well, when she applied for the visa, she informed the visa officer that she was previously denied a visa. And then when she came to the US, she filed the green card application by herself. There's a question on the form that indicates, have you ever been denied a visa? Well, her and her husband didn't really know what this meant. They were under the assumption that since she already disclosed this to the visa officer when she applied for her visa, that she no longer had to answer yes to this question, because maybe the question was referring to whether or not she was denied a visa after she came to the US. So they answered no, thinking that they can explain this to immigration. This couple used an online immigration form builder. I think it was called Immigration Express or some other form builder. And the problem with form builders is that they help you fill out the forms, but they don't tell you how you should answer. So the couple applied for a green card, and in the end it was denied because immigration said that she made a material misrepresentation when she indicated that she was never denied a visa. So if you're watching at home, just remember that if you fill out the forms incorrectly, it will be used against you, and the immigration officers have that law that allows them to use it against you. So again, if you're watching at home, we hope that you have found all of these 9 tips very useful when applying for your green card application. If you have any questions about the tips that we have provided, feel free to leave a comment in the box below and we'll make sure to respond to each of the comments. But just remember, these are just 9 tips. When you hire an experienced law office, most likely that attorney has seen so many cases that, and they can give you so much more advice than this limited 9 pieces of tips that we're providing in this video. So again, my name is Attorney David Nguyen. This is Winning Law, and we hope that we have made immigration easier to understand.
At David Nguyen's Law Office, we are here to help you. We bring families together through immigration. And on the other hand, we help you find solutions. All your legal needs in the hands of people who care, who are there for you. We'll take care of your loved ones at the Law Office of David Nguyen.